Chlorophyll is a substance that gives plants their green color, and chlorophyll supplements in liquid or tablet form are becoming wildly popular these days because, as you can see on TikTok, the hashtag chlorophyll has 488 million views. It's a topic that's been getting a lot of hype, and I feel like it's important to talk about. This video will look at all the claimed benefits that chlorophyll water has, my thoughts on them, if drinking chlorophyll is safe in the long run, as well as if there are any side effects, and then finish off the video with some alternatives that you can try if, let's say, you decide you don't want to go with chlorophyll water. I know, unpopular opinion, right? Definitely stay tuned until the end of the video, as I'll also be revealing why green is not the only important color when it comes to eating healthy, as well as one side effect of chlorophyll that you've probably never even heard of. Hi guys, you've seen Arsalan Media Pharmacist here on YouTube. If you guys want to learn more about making informed decisions about your health and wellness in an easy to understand way, then consider hitting that red subscribe button down below to stay up to date with new weekly videos. Also, a super easy way to support the channel is to take 2 seconds to gently tap that like button down below. And since you did like the video, here's a picture of a cute squirrel. Now, without further ado, let's get straight into it. If you ever wondered why plants are green, it's due to chlorophyll. And chlorophyll is what helps plants perform photosynthesis. And if your middle school self remembers hearing that term, photosynthesis, then you probably already know that photosynthesis is the process where plants absorb energy from sunlight to create nutrients. And without chlorophyll, plants can't grow. And without plants, well, you wouldn't have much life. Which is why chlorophyll has been considered by some as the foundation of all life on Earth. But are there any benefits to drinking chlorophyll? First of all, let's take it back a little bit and look at the chlorophyll drops everyone is testing out with their water or in their drinks. You see, when you use chlorophyll drops, you're not using pure chlorophyll. It's actually chlorophyllin, which is a semi-synthetic mixture of sodium copper salts derived from chlorophyll. This is why if you're trying to buy it as a supplement, you'll likely see it called chlorophyllin, and because it contains copper and sodium, it'll actually make it easier for your body to absorb it. So speaking of the liquid versus the capsules, if you want to try chlorophyll, liquid supplements might be a better value because some studies suggest it gets absorbed more, which is something to keep in mind. And now as far as the benefits go, as some of you know, I'm a big fan of rigorous studies. We need much larger rigorous studies to evaluate all the potential health benefits that chlorophyll has been claimed to provide. You've probably heard that it's beneficial for a number of things like boosting energy, treating acne, preventing cancer, controlling body odor, and the big one, weight loss. Do you guys remember the craze that was all about wheatgrass back in the day? Well, it was primarily because of that amount of chlorophyll in wheatgrass, and they attributed the same benefits that they do for chlorophyll to wheatgrass, which I thought was interesting. But what does the research say? The research points out that chlorophyll has tremendous antioxidant and anti-inflammatory properties. Yes, it indeed does have amazing properties, but it's far too early to say it should be considered a cure-all for any of the benefits I mentioned. With that said though, there was one interesting study that looked at the use of chlorophyll for weight loss that found that those who took a green plant membrane supplement with chlorophyll once a day actually had greater weight loss in a group that didn't take the supplement. But again, the study only featured women and there was only 38 participants, which isn't enough to make a strong case for because that's too little of a sample size. And another study looking at the use for chlorophyll to restore normal body odor looked at people with trimethylaminuria, which is a condition that causes a fishy body odor. And they found that chlorophyllin significantly decreased the amount of trimethylamines and helped with body odor. Again, super cool, but more studies are needed to evaluate that. Now let's take a look at whether or not it's safe to use, because that's another thing, right? Surely not everything on TikTok is safe to try at home, right?
Don't try this shit at home!
Researchers at Oregon State University found no toxic effects on chlorophyllin, and it does appear safe to use in moderation. But with that said, you should know about some of the side effects of using chlorophyll. There are 3 side effects that are commonly reported when drinking chlorophyll. The first is you'll have discolored poop, mostly of a green hue, which isn't harmful. It could just be alarming to see at first, but if you don't mind that, then it's okay. The second is stomach pain. It's usually mild and doesn't last long, and some don't report it at all, whereas with others, it can be a little bothersome and can lead to diarrhea. And lastly, the one that I mentioned to you earlier that you probably would never think of, and one that you definitely need to know before trying it, is photosensitization. No, not photosynthesis, as humans don't do that to my knowledge. There's an increased risk of sunburn for those using chlorophyll drops, so avoid exposure to sunlight or tanning beds if you're going to be using the drops on a daily basis. Chlorophyllin can make you sunburn more easily, so I always recommend to wear protective clothing and use an SPF of 30 or more when you are outdoors. And lastly, let's take a look at alternatives. If not chlorophyll, then what? If you really want to boost your chlorophyll intake, take your grocery cart from the snack aisle to the produce and stack it with a bunch of green vegetables instead. From a health standpoint, you'd be better off spending that money on vegetables, as you'll be getting fiber with them at the same time. And plus, chlorophyll ain't cheap. But you know what is? Arugula, parsley, and a $4 bag of spinach. Comment down below if you use chlorophyll drops or if you're a human that does photosynthesis. I'd love to hear your thoughts below. Click that red subscribe button and share what someone you think would benefit from this video. And until then, guys, I'll see you on the next one.